I'm Dr. Charles Sides, professor in the Communications Media Department, and it is my honor to serve as your Master of Ceremonies. The commencement ceremony combines traditions unique to Fitchburg State University and rituals common to colleges and universities across the United States. At every Fitchburg State sub-commencement, the university's colors, green, white, and gold, are prominent. Each color was chosen to signify an ideal. White symbolizes purity and perfection. Green is inspiration. Gold represents wisdom. Other university symbols include the saxifrage flower. In 1900, the saxifrage, known as the rock breaker, was chosen to represent the spirit of what was then Fitchburg Normal School. The flower was chosen for its, quote, moral lesson in the achievements that can be brought about by quiet willpower, unquote. The motto, perseverantia, meaning perseverance or persistence, has remained unchanged for a century and is prominent in our seal. While the university colors and saxifrage are unique to Fitchburg State, other traditions are common to graduations across the United States. Most significant of these are the academic regalia worn by all the participants. The origins of academic regalia can be traced back to the 13th century. At that time, they were the daily attire. Today, they are only worn for ceremonies, but they tell us much about the wearer. For graduate students, the traditional black gowns have oblong sleeves open at the wrist, with the front part cut in an arc. They will be wearing their hoods for the conferral of their degrees. All faculty and administrators wear the gowns associated with the university where they earned their degree. Faculty may be wearing black, red, maroon, blue, or brown gowns today. The hood, which is the colorful part of the regalia worn around the neck, indicates the wearer's degree and place of study. Each hood is lined with the official colors of the college or university awarding the degree. The binding identifies the graduate's academic discipline, and the length of the hood and the width of the binding increase with the importance of the degree. Each member of the processional also wears a mortarboard or a soft hat with a tassel. Doctoral hats have gold tassels, master's degrees have black tassels, and undergraduate tassels feature the university colors. Watch for these distinctions as the processional begins. Several of the groups participating in the processional this evening will be led by a gonfalonier. The gonfalonier carries the banner or gonfalon representing that particular assembly. The gonfalon is a long banner that is suspended from a crossbar, which originated in the medieval republics of Italy as an ensign of state or office. Gonfalons have been adopted by many universities around the world as college or institutional insignias. As we prepare to welcome the university processional for the start of our ceremony, please note that during the commencement ceremony, access to the stage area will be prohibited. The Fitchburg State Alumni Association has hired a professional photographer who will take a picture of each graduate as they receive their degree and congratulations from Vice President Canny. Each graduate will receive a complimentary 5x7 photograph mailed to their home. The ceremony is also being streamed live tonight by Fitchburg Access TV and is captioned for the deaf and hard of hearing. DVDs and Blu-rays of the ceremony will be available for purchase from FATV. Please note that the captioning for this event is also available on your mobile device through our website at fitchburgstate.edu/captioning. In the unlikely event it becomes necessary to evacuate the building, there are 5 exits around the perimeter of this room. And now, please rise as you are able to welcome the Fitchburg State University processional for the 2022 graduate commencement. First, first to enter are the alumni. The alumni are led by Jasmine Yang from the classes of 2011 and 2020, who is carrying the alumni gonfalon. James Walsh from the class of 1975 is the most senior alumnus in attendance today. Each of the alumni participating today is wearing a yellow stole to represent the Alumni Association. The faculty is led by the recipients of the university's prestigious faculty awards. Dr. Elizabeth Gordon, the 2021 recipient of the Vincent J. Mara Award for Excellence in Teaching, is carrying the university mace, which is a symbol typically found at academic ceremonies. Also leading the faculty is Dr. James Alicata, recipient of the 2021 Contributions to the Graduate Program Award. He is carrying the faculty gonfalon. All of the faculty award winners are wearing stoles that commemorate their accolades. Graduate students are now entering, organized by the four academic schools within the university. Jennifer Belfield, recipient of tonight's Graduate Student Leadership Award, is carrying the gonfalon, leading her fellow graduate students in the processional. Thank you. entering is the Platform Party, led by Ms. Deborah Phillips, Chair of the Board of Trustees. Chair Phillips will officially confer the degrees on today's graduates. The Platform Party includes honored guests, local elected leaders, and senior university administrators. The platform precedes Dr. Catherine Canny, Provost and Vice President of Fitchburg State University.
Vice President Canny, honored guests, graduates, faculty, librarians, administrators, and staff members, ladies and gentlemen, I hereby convene these commencement exercises marking the completion of the 128th year of Fitchburg State University and celebrating the achievements of the 126th graduating class. My name is Franca Baricelli, the Interim Associate Vice President for Academic Affairs, and I welcome you to tonight's celebration. President Lapidus was looking forward to celebrating this occasion with our graduates, campus community, and honored guests, but is unable to join us this evening because of unforeseen circumstances. He asked that I share his warmest wishes and congratulations to the class of 2022 on his behalf. The Montechusett Regional Vocational Technical School Marine Corps Junior ROTC members will present the colors. I ask that you please remain standing. Please join the Fitchburg State University Chamber Choir, directed by Professor Jonathan Harvey, in the class of 2022 in singing the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you.
Please be seated. I am pleased to present Ms. Deborah Phillips, Chair of the Board of Trustees.
Good evening. On behalf of the Board of Trustees and the entire campus community, it is my privilege to welcome you to the graduate ceremony of our university's 126 commencement exercises. To tonight's graduates, know that all of us are honored to join you in this celebration. Be assured that the educational experiences you have received at this university will help you adapt and prosper in your future endeavors. Our university's talented and committed faculty members have broadened your outlook, increased your intellectual curiosity, and encouraged you to explore new ways of learning and growing. I hope you will take this gift of learning and share it with others. The skills you acquired here will serve you well in your professional and personal lives. Rest assured that you leave this university today well-equipped to make positive impacts on your professions and your communities wherever you go from here. Congratulations to each and every one of you.
Thank you, Chair Phillips. I am pleased to present State Representative Michael Kuchmerich, who brings greetings from the Commonwealth.
Thank you, Dr. Baricelli. I'm honored to be here this evening to provide greetings on behalf of your Massachusetts House of Representatives. As a two-time alumnus of this great institution, it is especially gratifying for me to share this moment with all of you. I know how hard you have worked to be in those seats tonight. Through long hours of study and the constant grind of juggling work and personal lives, you kept your eyes on the goal, and tonight you have achieved it. The determination and perseverance that got you here today is exactly what typifies what it means to be a Fitchburg State Falcon. It will also be what differentiates you in the workforce and in life. You have proven that you are the very best and the brightest that our Commonwealth has to offer. Our Commonwealth and our country need you in this moment. Beyond the knowledge that you have no doubt acquired during your time in the classroom at Fitchburg State, I want to encourage you to consider lending your talents to public service in your communities and throughout the Commonwealth. Whether through elected office, volunteering, or serving on a local board or commission, or working in the public sector, I promise you, you will find civic engagement both rewarding and valuable, and in turn, it will help your communities thrive. Tonight, though, is about honoring your accomplishment. Embrace this moment. Be proud of what you have achieved. Know that the possibilities are endless. One day, I hope to see you around the State House. Thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you, Representative Kuchmerich. I'm now pleased to present Dr. Rayla Jakite, President of the Fitchburg State University Chapter of the MSCA.
Good evening. To the students, families, friends, and well-wishers gathered here, I bring greetings from the faculty and librarians of Fitchburg State University. On behalf of my colleagues, I offer heartfelt congratulations to all the students receiving graduate degrees tonight. Though your paths were not all the same, thanks to your persistence and focus, you have come together in this great hall to celebrate the successful completion of your studies. After guiding you in the study of your chosen fields, we are proud to witness your progress and look forward to following your future endeavors. And your achievement is all the more special as you all studied, learned, and blossomed in the most unusual of circumstances. These past few years were like the crossing of a dangerous pass, reminding us of our human frailty. Now that the pandemic seems to be waning, perhaps you will look back and find that you discovered unknown strengths and recognized the value of human connections and community. Your degree thus represents an exceptional accomplishment. Given my role in the faculty union, I wish to encourage all of you who are graduating today to remember that we, as a community of scholars and practitioners and people who have come to know you, believe in you. We are here to support you for years to come. And you are forever connected to our university. Even while you are individuals setting out on unique journeys, remember that you are part of this community, as well as many others. I urge you to take your place in those communities, share your knowledge, and work together to improve the world you find before you as proud graduates of Fitchburg State University. Thank you.
Thank you, Rayla. It is now my pleasure to ask Mr. Jim Walsh, class of 1975 and president of the Alumni Association, to say a few words.
Thank you, Dr. Baricelli. Class of 75, you'll be needing these eventually. Good evening and welcome to all of our honored guests here this evening, and especially to those of you seated before me, our future alumni. It is an honor and a privilege for me to be here and to be a very small part of acknowledging the accomplishments that you achieve in being here tonight. Thank you. As president of the Fitchburg State Alumni Association, I am proud that tonight we will welcome many of you as our newest alumni members. And I also want to acknowledge and welcome many of you who tonight will become double Falcons, people who received their bachelor's degree from Fitchburg State and now have a graduate degree as well. And it's very possible that some of you may be triple Falcons, so congratulations. You will join an elite group of more than 49,000 proud alumni from coast to coast and around the world. These graduates have helped pave the way for you today and provide an incredible networking and support opportunity for you as you transition through your career. We are here for you today and will be with you in the future as you will forever be Fitchburg State Falcons. On behalf of the Alumni Association, I am also excited to provide you with a small gift. This evening, as you receive your degree from Dr. Canny on stage, the photograph that is taken of you will be mailed to you in commemoration of your achievement. We hope that it will serve as a proud reminder of this great accomplishment and will inspire you to stay connected to your alma mater. Congratulations once again. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. It is now my pleasure to introduce the interim provost and vice president for academic affairs, Dr. Catherine Canny.
Thank you, and good evening. I'd like to begin by welcoming our honored guests representing our Board of Trustees, including Chair Deborah Phillips, from whom we heard a moment ago, as well as Vice Chair Lynn Berrio and Alumni Representative Eric Gregoire. Local and state elected leaders, including Representative Kuzmarek and Gardner Mayor Michael Nicholson. University administrators, including Vice President for Advancement Jeffrey Wolfman, Vice President for Student Affairs Laura Bayless, Dean of the School of Graduate Online and Continuing Education Becky Copper-Glenz, Dean of Education and Business Nancy Murray, Dean of Arts and Sciences Sarah Levine, Dean of Health and Natural Sciences Meg Hoey, and Dean of the Library Jackie Kremer. I also want to welcome our alumni who personify the institution and its traditions. Thank you all for being part of this celebration. I'd also like to thank the members of our university staff who have done so much to get our graduates to tonight's celebration, as well as organizing tonight's event. I would also like to recognize our distinguished faculty, who bring out the very best in our students. I know that it means a lot to our students, and to me as well, that you are here to celebrate with them and recognize their achievements. Faculty, if you would please stand and be recognized. And now to our graduates. Good evening, class of 2022. It's really wonderful to look around and see our Fitchburg State University community gathered here tonight. I know that we've been all waiting for this moment, and I can't be more excited to watch this class of graduates walk across the stage and to tell each of you in person how incredibly proud I am of your performance, your accomplishments during these past few very challenging years. You deserve to feel tremendously proud of your achievement. Along with our traditional campus-based students, we also welcome students from across the country and internationally that have studied online and represent 30 states and 8 countries. For those that are on campus for the first time, there are some of you here, we are honored to have you join us tonight. Let me begin by congratulating all of you on your accomplishments. Tonight is special and represents the culmination of years of hard work, and it's my privilege to be part of this celebration that recognizes your achievement. We are pleased that each of you has invested in your future here, believing in the value of higher education. I know that it will serve you well. Commencement is an exciting and emotional time for you and your family, and we are honored that Fitchburg State University has been part of your growth. As you reflect back on your experience as a student, I am sure that you didn't arrive here tonight on your own. There were many people who shared your ups and downs along the way. It might have been a special professor who led you through a rough patch or helped nurture a good idea. Or the sacrifices that your parents, family, spouse, or partner made so that you could walk across the stage tonight. So graduates, please join me in thanking them for all of their support and give them a well-deserved round of applause. Today, we need students with advanced degrees more than ever. Only 8% of the American population holds a master's degree, so you are joining in a select group. A recent report by the Commission on the Future of Graduate Education indicated that our competitiveness in the global economy hinges on our ability to produce sufficient numbers of graduate degree holders. People with the advanced knowledge and critical thinking abilities to devise solutions to grand challenges, such as energy independence, affordable health care, and climate change, among others. One of our greatest resources is our human talent. The study goes on to state, and as a nation, we must invest in educating more of our population at the graduate level to ensure our capacity to innovate and to secure our intellectual leadership into the future. Currently, the world is moving at a faster pace than at any other period in human history. We are more global than ever before and are experiencing social, cultural, and political transformations, almost all of which are tied together by the power of technology. Given this scenario, problems created by change are also occurring with increased speed and complexity. Thus, we need our graduate students more than ever to work on solutions to some of the world's most challenging problems. And I am confident that you are prepared with new skills, new credentials, and an improved understanding of the world in which we live in. Take those skills and that understanding and apply them to your career and your personal life. As each of you reflects upon your future and the opportunities that lie ahead, I'd like to share a few additional hopes that I have for you. I hope that each of you will consider your work to be more than a job. Make sure you're doing something that you consider to be meaningful, are passionate about it, and will always do it with pride. Don't forget to dream big. Without dreams, you'll be defined by limits rather than possibilities. There are plenty of examples of today's realists that in the future will be found to have been very short-sighted. We believe in a world of becoming, a place where change is a constant. Our future will be determined by those of you willing to imagine how it will be better and work hard for it. I encourage you to contribute your skills and talent beyond your employer and use them to make a difference in your community. The ability to empathize with others, to listen to people at a time when it seems as though everyone is talking at you rather than talking to you, to stand up for someone who can't defend themselves or just being there to help someone in their time is important. I hope that each of you will always view the world from the upside. We're living in a time when it's easy to be cynical. Stay positive, as negativity will pull both you and others around you down. Remember that your perspective matters. How you view the world and your efforts moving forward can be a self-fulfilling prophecy. Further, that perspective will impact others around you. Encourage others, celebrate with them their accomplishments, and downplay their shortcomings, as it will make both your life and theirs richer. I hope that you will always show respect for others. We live in a complex and multifaceted world that offers a broad range of perspectives on virtually every topic. You don't have to like everyone you meet, nor do you need to support their beliefs, but respect and civility go a long way to bridging divides. There will always be people who think that being louder is better or that belittling is a strategy, but I think you will find that is not a winning approach. Finally, I hope that you are always able to find ways to have fun. That is not always as easy as it seems to be. We often find ourselves confronted with increased responsibility, and the everyday challenges and commitments we have taken on become overwhelming and prevent us from having time to have fun and enjoy life to its fullest. But having fun is important, and finding ways to smile and laugh more is what makes life enjoyable both for us and the people around us. Life moves pretty fast, and if you don't stop and look around once in a while, you're going to miss it. So make sure that you experience the joy in life and find time to have a little fun. Please know that we are all very proud of your accomplishments and take great comfort in knowing that each of you is well prepared for the challenges ahead and that you are destined to do great things. Also know that we will always be here to support you, and though you graduate tonight, Fitchburg State will always be your home. It is my hope that you will remain connected to the faculty, the staff, and to your classmates, and we look forward to hearing of your great successes. Congratulations to the class of 2022. It is now my privilege to present the Graduate Student Leadership Award. This honor is bestowed in recognition of demonstrated leadership in the student's professional work, graduate studies, or disciplinary research, and is presented based on recommendations from faculty and administration. Our honoree tonight is Jennifer Belfield. Jennifer Belfield has distinguished herself as a member of the Fitchburg State community since the start of her undergraduate studies. She began her journey in the game design program with a minor in computer science. Her first computer science class included setting goals, all of which she set about completing to very high standards. Jennifer graduated in 2019 with a bachelor's degree and immediately enrolled in Fitchburg State's master's program in computer science. She continued to set high expectations for herself, including a goal of a perfect 4.0 grade point average. This, too, she achieved. She completes her journey at Fitchburg State tonight and will move on to a PhD program at Worcester Polytechnic Institute, where she received the very competitive CEDAR Fellowship. We have every confidence she will continue to set and meet her high standards. Jennifer, I invite you to address your fellow graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Canny. Good evening, fellow classmates, families, and faculty.
First, I would like to thank my parents, to whom I'm grateful for being with me every step of the way. Dad, thank you for always encouraging me to pursue computer science, for going apartment hunting for me at WPI while I was in the crunch of finals, for praying and cheering for me for my every success. Sue, thank you for your prayers, cheers of support, your help to me in getting my new apartment, and for sharing stories with me. I would like to thank my professors for nominating me for the Graduate Student Leadership Award and for all their inspiration and support. Thank you, Dr. Ricky Sadie. When you asked us to write our class goals on a survey sheet at the beginning of a long ago semester, I dared to fiercely scrawl out my career dreams onto the survey sheet, hardly imagining that what would become of that action was finding myself standing amidst those dreams. Thank you, Dr. Natasha Kurtonina. Words cannot describe how wonderful a professor you are. Thank you, Dr. Brady Chen, for helping me to feel brave about taking next steps and meeting new professors. Thank you, Dr. John Russo, for your support, encouragement, and surprising me with your insights, especially about autism, which is a topic very close to my heart. Thank you, Dr. Robin Chatot, for your positivity and encouragement. Thank you, Dr. Marianne Barbado, for opening up doors for me in math that I will never forget. I feel very proud to have professors who care and are so knowledgeable. My learning experiences with all of you have been important times in my ongoing school journey. To all of my classmates and colleagues here graduating with me tonight, when we envisioned graduate school, none of us imagined that the experience would happen during a global pandemic. Reaching this accomplishment is a community success. As learning in person became learning remotely, in-person group studying became reaching out and studying together remotely too. I know I personally couldn't have done it without every single one of you here, and I'm sure looking back, everyone feels the same way. We all accomplished our goals as a team of colleagues. I think about times I felt sad or discouraged, and I remember my fears washing away just by the smiles on your faces and your helpful words, which gave me confidence and said to me, you're not alone, we're all in this together. Fitchburg State University is a place that connects me to my dreams and recharges me with that positive Fitchburg State University community energy. Fitchburg State University is my home. Working together has made us all grow. I love how here at Fitchburg State, students help each other learn. Experiencing this has been so inspiring. So many times I've wondered, how in the world did that person know how to explain that concept to me so clearly so that it makes sense to me? I felt so happy whenever I've gotten to be that person who could help out a classmate. Learning here at Fitchburg State University has always been a two-way street. Even when I was the one to help out a classmate learn something, I ended up learning something from them. I remember so often thinking, wow, I would never have thought of that. There is nothing like getting the benefit of each other's perspectives. Fitchburg State University has prepared me for exciting work in data science. I've come through feeling empowered to learn. Realizing I can do work that interests me is very exciting and inspiring. I so enjoy being able to do what I am passionate about. When I still feel scared sometimes by the thought of what I haven't learned in school yet, I have courage when I remember where my journey has brought me and my confidence returns, reminding me that I can still go much further. I'm so grateful for my education and the encouragement I receive as I walk towards my dreams and ambitions. Thanks to everyone here, we did it. Whatever our next steps look like or wherever they take us, it will never be the same thanks to these valuable insights we all gained and shared together as Fitchburg State University community members. Thank you all for making this journey together.
Thank you, Jennifer, for your inspiring words. And now, in recognition of your leadership skills, your scholarly contributions, and enduring ambitions, we are honored to present you the Graduate Student Leadership Award. Congratulations.
Thank you, Jennifer, and congratulations again. The Inabata Brass will now perform variations on a theme by Haydn while we prepare for the awarding of the degrees.
Will the candidates for graduate degrees please come forward? I would ask that Chair Deborah Phillips of the Board of Trustees and Dr. Baricelli, Interim Associate Vice President for Academic Affairs, to please join me for the conferring of graduate degrees. Honorable ladies and gentlemen, I present to you these persons who I know to be sufficient in knowledge according to the customs of the ancient and revered universities for the degrees of Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study, Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Education, and Master of Science.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Higher Education of Massachusetts and the Fitchburg State University Board of Trustees, I am pleased to grant these candidates their certificates or degrees with all the rights and privileges appertaining thereunto.
Would the chairpersons for each graduate program please present their candidates?
School of Arts and Sciences, Certificate of Advanced Graduate Study, degree in Interdisciplinary Studies, led by Dr. Rayla Jakite. Master of Arts degree in History, led by Dr. Daniel Sarefield. Robert P. Hawkins. Master of Science degree in Applied Communication, led by Dr. Viera Lorenkova. Naila Adu. Zoe Elizabeth Eisenhower. Amy M. Johnson. Anne L. Larson. Mary Schwalm. Master of Science degree in Counseling, led by Dr. Deneen Deptula. Rachel Ashley Andler. Jennifer Cassandra Angrand. Kelly Elizabeth Cormier. Dana Rose Gray. Heaven A. Griffin. Amy Lee Hanna. Nicole M. Kujala. Mary Elizabeth Madrigal. Megan Elizabeth McCarthy. Brooke Elizabeth Merrifield. Kelly M. Nolan. Katrin M. O'Rourke. Casey Mariah Panarelli. Sarah Renee Perriman. Emanuela Y. Tam. Jasmine Welch. Soteria Zuzas. Master of Science degree in Criminal Justice, led by Dr. Richard Wiebe. William David Bento. K. Kelly Brianna McCusker Brown. School of Business, Master of Business Administration, Degree in Business Administration, led by Drs. Beverly Hollingsworth and Denise Simeon. Octavian Abrahams. Orlando P. Acero. Melissa C. Lee Adigan. Lencho German Amente. Omar Tarek Ayoub. Sachin Sudhakaro Bakad. Fatima Dabina Baptista. Jessica Ashley Barron. Tremaine J. Bell. Rudolph Reko Boampong. Nicole Joan Borgeson. Joseph S. Bowen, Jr. Jesse Brown Martin. Brittany Bryan. Jacqueline M. Kensell. Adrian F. Castro Cardoso. Joao da Silva. Chelsea Danis. Danielle M. Dufault. Jeremy Dunn. Mary Elder. Nashlir Solveka Ernest.
Olive M. Fagan. Ronald Akeem Fagan. Toby Buscemi. Hannah Marie Ford. Jeffrey West Ford. Ashley Denise Harrison. Kamar Hassan. V. Hong. Damika T. Jason Arnold Hutton. Elaine J. Jackson. Aisha Josma. Richard William Kane. Olga Kavalenka. Jeffrey Gavin Kelleher. Sally Correa. Good luck, Patrick Lama. Erin Kate LePrad. Kinga Laska Bostock. Lensley Marlon Millett. Jiwen Liu. Emerson Leandro Loaiza Gonzalez.
Joshua R. McCumber. Brittany R. Madden. Ibrahima Ball. Natasha Nicole Mack. Kathleen Elizabeth McKinstry. Lucy Carolina Mendoza. Charles Scott Morris. Aravind Narayanan. Derek Gofak Nedwin. Haley Noel. Arma Osama Ohenye Seichi. Pendre Paula Felicia. James Lee Pleasant Jr. Karen Lynn Reed. Valerie Remy. Chanel Olivia Roche. Francine C. Rogers. Jonathan Andrew Ryan. Nikki Ann Schwartz. Hannah Simons. Ravish Shavastava. Keandru Alkiros T. Jeannie G. Texera. N.M. Pita Budongwa. Lasharita Jenkins Wilson. Tygon Yilmaz. Rayshon Devin Zavala. School of Education, led by Dr. Philip Saza. Joseph Arthur Wright.
Master of Education degree in Curriculum and Teaching, led by Dr. Ann Howard and Dr. Michael Hanna. Elena Archipretti. Caitlin Elizabeth Bernard. Heather Marie Bonner. Kevin Tyler Brunell. Michaela Campbell. Mm-hmm. Amy Renee Kadir. Candace Lynn Como. Anna A. Cummings. Sarah Amy Durkin Goonan. Ashley Jean Frias. Amanda Murphy. Caitlin J. M. Murphy. Lon Wen. Caroline E. Nichols. Andrea Jane Novello. Jessica J. Smith. Natalie Francis Uribe. Paula Mary Janet Whalen. Master of Education degree in Early Childhood Education, led by Dr. Lindsay Ben-Harris. Susan A. Ketty. Jessica Christine Lutinsky. Kayla Ann Mercurio. Master of Education degree in Educational Leadership and Management, led by Dr. Philip Siza. Bree V. Ashy. Laurel Brown. Flossie Calderon. Kelly Ann Kavicki. Victoria Ward Lewis. It's Virgie Lewis. Woo! Susan Riga. Megan Carlson Ritter. Raina Liz Silva. Carla Marie Vasquez. Master's degree in elementary education, 1 through 6, led by Dr. Lindsay Ben-Harris. Alicia M. Bizzotto. Lydia Ann Booth. Master of Education degree in special education, led by Drs. Jessica Abamo Gannon and Dr. Robert Shapiro. Matthew Cavanaugh. Nicole Noreen Fetter. Megan A. Flaherty. Valerie E. Hillier. Kelly Ann Masonet. Lorelei Neuse. Ashley Rose Majinski. Amanda Paige Palmer Rosado. Rachel Grace Strout. Suzanne Thomas. Megan Elizabeth Thompson. Macy Renee Woodard. Kelly Marie Young. School of Health and Natural Sciences. Master of Education degree in Occupational Education, led by Dr. James Alicata. Christina Elizabeth Lopez. Woo! Master of Education degree in Science Education, led by Dr. Liz Gordon. Darcy Marie Dryley. Master of Science degree in Computer Science, led by Dr. Brady Chen. Fatin Ali Alabas. Jennifer Belfield. Srikanth Chopram. Lakshmi Chanana Gamagari. Shaker Sumun Chintanipu. Firdos. Mirai Iren. Audrey Marie Maya. Robert Charles Parker. Shravani Vera Pieretti. Master of Science degree in Forensic Nursing, led by Dr. Deborah Stone. Hope Gadea Miller. Louise Frances Sheehan.
Tonight's graduate students remain standing and everyone else sit. Thank you. To our graduates, each of you has worked hard to advance your understanding of your chosen disciplines and move on tonight ready to be improved practitioners in your field. We look forward to hearing of all your accomplishments. Let us give our graduate students of the class of 2022 a round of applause.
Graduates, for allowing Fitchburg State to be such an important part of your academic and intellectual growth. We have now reached the conclusion of our ceremony. The platform party will recess, and we ask faculty, librarians, students, alumni, and guests to remain at your seat until they have departed. I now declare the graduate commencement ceremony in the 128th year of Fitchburg State University closed. Congratulations, everyone.